Namaste students, welcome back again in our student postpost YouTube channel. It's time to start our new part, part number 8. In this video, we will discuss about the chemical properties of halogens. In the previous video, we have to discuss about the physical properties of the halogens. Let's start students from the chemical properties. Students, you know that halogens are more reactive. Halogens are more reactive. Due to this, their nature is polar. Due to more reactive, why it is more reactive? Because their nature is polar. See, how it is polar? This is the CX bond. This is CX bond. Here, you know that halogen having high EN, high electronegativity, it pulls the electron towards itself and acquires partial negative charge. And carbon having partial positive charge. Due to this nature, the halogen shows more reactive nature. Okay. Now move towards the chemical properties of halogens. The properties of halogens occurs in following four ways. The properties, chemical properties of halogens occurs in four ways. First one is NSR, nucleophilic substitution reaction. Then elimination reaction. Elimination reaction को हम क्या कहते हैं? विलोपन अभिक्रिया. First one, nucleophilic substitution reaction को क्या कहते हैं? नाभिक स्नेही प्रतिस्थापन अभिक्रिया. Third one is reduction, upchain अभिक्रिया. And fourth one is reaction with metal, धातुओं के साथ क्रिया. So, these are the four methods to form other products from halogens. Now, start from first one, that is NSR, nucleophilic substitution reaction. Students, what is nucleophilic substitution reaction? See, if any stronger nucleophile displace or substitute the weakest nucleophile, then the product form, this reaction is known as nucleophilic substitution reaction. जब कोई एक stronger nucleophile किसी दुर्बल नाभिक स्नेही को displace करता है, weaker nucleophile को displace करता है और एक new product का formation करता है, this complete reaction is known as nucleophilic substitution reaction. One nucleophile substitute another nucleophile. Which nucleophile substitute? Stronger nucleophile substitute weaker nucleophile. Let's understand by a reaction. You know that OH is a stronger nucleophile and on a react with RX halogen. When stronger nucleophile, that is OH negative hydroxyl ion, on react with halogen, here X is the nucleophile. In halogen, X halogen part is nucleophile. This is weaker than the incoming hydroxyl ion. This OH minus ion substitute this halogen ion. This OH minus ion substitute this X minus ion from this halogen and we will get ROH. This is a new nucleophile product, ROH. Similarly, we can say that हम यहाँ क्या कह सकते हैं कि stronger nucleophile ने एक weaker nucleophile को क्या किया बच्चों? Substitute किया और एक new product का formation हुआ. इस complete reaction को क्या बोला हमने? Nucleophilic substitution reaction कहा. Nucleophilic substitution reactions, students, occurs in two ways. नाभिक स्नेही प्रतिस्थापन अभिक्रिया दो तरीकों से होती है. First one is SN1, second one is SN2. SN1, here S stands for substitution, N for nucleophilic, and 1 is for unimolecular. 1 stands for unimolecular. Here S stands for substitution, N stands for nucleophilic, and 2 stands for bimolecular. So it is called as unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction, and it is called as bimolecular nucleophilic substitution. Now we will understand completely by their differences. First one is unimolecular nucleophilic substitution. It is called as bimolecular nucleophilic substitution. The rate of reaction in HNO mechanism is depend only on the concentration of substrate molecule. In HNO mechanism, rate of reaction depends directly proportional to the concentration of substrate only. Here you see that R equals to K Rx. Here Rx is the reactant part, that is the substrate part. Or K, what is K? K is the proportionality constant. So we can say that rate of reaction in HNO mechanism depends only on the concentration of substrate. But in SN2, rate of reaction depends on substrate as well as on the concentration of incoming nucleophile. See here, R equals to K. K is the proportionality constant. On removing proportionality sign, what is the substrate? That is heavy alkane part, and the incoming part is nucleophile, the concentration of nucleophile. That means SN2 mechanism depends on both substrate as well as incoming nucleophile. Then the next part is SN1 mechanism proceeds in two steps. Students, SN1 mechanism proceeds in two steps. But the SN2 mechanism proceeding only single step, one step. How it will be proceeding two step? Ye do step mein kaise proceed hoga? In step 1, formation of carbocation occurs. In SN1, in first step, formation of carbocation occurs. This step is known as slow step. Yeh step dhimi gati ka hoga. Isiliye hum isko kya kehte hain? Rate determining step bhi kehte hain. Rate determining step, also known as the slow step. In this step, we say that formation of carbocation occurs. How? On the heterolytic cleavage of this heteroalkane part. This is the Rx. On heterolytic cleavage, X is the more electronegative. It pulls the electron towards itself and acquires negative charge, and the carbocation is formed. Here R plus is the carbocation. In first step, carbocation is formed. Now, in the second step, this carbocation fastly react with the incoming nucleophile. We can also say that the incoming nucleophile fastly attack on the carbocation and form a new product, that is RNU. NU is the nucleophile, incoming nucleophile, which are attached on the carbocation. This step is fast step. So, इसीलिए हम इसको क्या कह सकते हैं बच्चों? This is two step reaction. But here the reaction proceeds in only one step. In this mechanism, in SN2 mechanism, OH negative is the incoming nucleophile. We can say that it is the stronger nucleophile than the leaving group chloride ion. इस मैकेनिज्म में OH नेगेटिव आयन अटैक करेगा फ्रॉम द ऑपोजिट साइड ऑफ क्लोरीन आयन, जो आपका लिविंग ग्रुप है, जस्ट उसके ऑपोजिट साइड से आपका इनकमिंग न्यूक्लियोफाइल अटैक करेगा एंड मेक्स अ ट्रांजिशन स्टेट. और क्या बनाएगा? सबसे पहले एक ट्रांजिशन स्टेट बनाएगा. इट इज नोन एज संक्रमण अवस्था भी कहते हैं इसे. इट इज नोन एज ट्रांजिशन स्टेट. दिस स्टेट एक्सप्लेन्स दैट the incoming nucleophile and the leaving nucleophile both having loose bonds. दोनों के पास क्या है? Loose bonds है. इसका अर्थ ये है, न ही incoming nucleophile permanently join हुआ और न ही हमारा leaving group जो है हमारा वो permanently यहाँ से leave हुआ, उसने अपनी जगह को छोड़ा. After the transition state, transition state is unstable state. यह स्टेट कैसी है? अनस्टेबल है, अस्थाई है. आफ्टर दैट फास्ट रिएक्शन अकर्स एंड वी विल गेट ए न्यू प्रोडक्ट ऑफ न्यू न्यूक्लियोफाइल एंड लिविंग ग्रुप Cl- आयन आर फ्री. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ SN2. देन इन SN1 मैकेनिज्म बोथ रेसिमाइजेशन एंड इन्वर्जन टेक्स प्लेस. व्हाट इज रेसिमाइजेशन? रेसिमाइजेशन मींस D एंड L मिक्सचर्स आर फॉर्म. D यानी डेस्ट्रो रोटेटरी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन एंड लेवो रोटेटरी मींस एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन का मूवमेंट, बोथ मिक्सचर्स आर फॉर्म. दैट मींस वी कैन से दैट दिस प्रोसेस इज नोन एज रेसिमाइजेशन. And inversion also takes place. This inversion we can see here in this reaction SN2 mechanism, where the nucleophile attack from the back side, from the opposite side of the leaving group. We can say that in SN1 mechanism both configurations takes place, racemization and inversion. But in SN2 only inversion of configuration takes place. You can see in the above case. Now the last part, that is SN1 order. What is SN1 order? This is the order of reactivity. This order of reactivity depends upon the order of stability of carbocation. Order of stability of carbocation. So benzyl halides are more reactive than halide, which are more reactive than 3 degree, then 2 degree, which are more reactive than 1 degree, and 1 degree more reactive than normal methyl halides. But SN2 mechanism are just opposite to the SN1 mechanism. Their order of reactivity just opposite to the SN1 mechanism. Here methyl halide is more reactive than 1 degree, 1 degree more reactive than 2 degree, and is more reactive than 3 degree, and 3 degree more reactive than halide, and halide is more reactive than benzyl halides. Here we can say that why this configuration, this reactivity order changes, because here the steric hindrance occurs. In SN2 mechanism, steric hindrance occurs. This steric hindrance changes the reactivity from tertiary to primary, more reactive. Okay students, कहने का मतलब यहाँ ये है कि यहाँ bulky groups ने हमारे उस कार्बन एटम को सराउंड किया है जिस पर हेलोजन एटम जुड़ा होगा. उस फैक्टर को क्या कहते हैं हम? स्टेरिक फैक्टर कहते हैं. सो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द मैकेनिज्म एंड डिफरेंस बिटवीन SN1 एंड SN2. दिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ आवर फर्स्ट रिएक्शन, दैट इज NSR. हाउ NSR रिएक्शंस प्रोसीड, व्हाट आर द रिएक्शंस प्रेजेंट इन द चैप्टर, वी विल डिस्कस इन अवर नेक्स्ट पार्ट. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, थैंक यू.